I was walking out of the bus stop near Hosono. Today is February 22nd, and this is a valley north of Kyoto. And I found that beautiful example of two grasses. Lots of similarities between this Miscanthus and Sada grass. So they have big, very tall stems. They have typical grass leaves. They have nice grass-like inflorescence. The only difference today, on February 22nd, is that Sada is alive, whereas Miscanthus stems are dead. So this is a core difference from bamboos to all other grasses. Bamboos, by definition, have perennial stems, perennial above ground stems. Interestingly, bamboo stems are also monocarpic, so they will flower and die, but that will happen not immediately. They will grow for many, many years until inflorescences will appear, and then stems will be destined to the death. Nevertheless, in both cases, there is very thick below ground rhizome system which allow to grow new stems. In case of Miscanthus, every year. In case of bamboo, they will be occasionally growing and supplying this big clonal bamboos with new stems. So this is how bamboos are different from typical grasses. Not the size again, not anything else, but just ability for bamboos to survive in bad seasons throughout many years until stems will develop flowers. It's quite necessarily, of course, that with perennial lifestyle, they develop kind of woodiness on the stem. Otherwise, stems will be vulnerable to plenty of infections and herbivores. But again, this is a consequence of the life strategy of bamboos. Plants which don't have perennial stems like Miscanthus, they might put less efforts to make stems very hard. So there is a good side of both strategies, strategy of typical grass and strategy of bamboo. Now, this is typical grass and bamboo in February. Thank you.